This video is for PBA 6 sem income tax in that assessment of individual and partnership form. So I am going to discuss about assessment of partnership form, which is important for 15 marks case study. So we look at the format first, that is assessment of partnership form. Calculation of total income, we need to add together all the heads of incomes. So firstly, we have to start the income from business. So net profit as per P&L account, add inadmissible expenses, less incomes chargeable under other heads or exempt incomes. So in addition to these two extra items will come for partnership form. You know these two calculations, right? Income from business, where you have to calculate net profit, add inadmissible expenses, less incomes chargeable under other heads or other source. So in addition to these two calculations, after doing these calculations, we just have to add salary to partners, any remunerations to partner, that means all the partners. So the thing is, we just have to add salary. It will be given in the question itself. So that will be added to this total income. So salary to partners or any other remunerations, it includes bonus, commissions, anything given to partners will be given taken here. So we have to add salary or remuneration to all the partners if already debited to P&L account. It is given in the P&L account on the debit side, so that will be added back. So after adding these amount, we'll get what? Book profit. So we have to follow the same method where we have to calculate the business incomes, and after doing these two calculations, extra is what? We have to add any remuneration paid to any partner which is already given in the P&L account. So that will be added back and you get what? Book profit, which is new to you. So book profit we have to calculate. So next, finding book profit, we have to less salary to working partners, that means only to working partners. For this we have to calculate as per the rule that will be discussed later. So less salary to working partners. After deducting salary to working partners, you'll get what? Income from business. So till here to here, it consists of income from business. So thing is what? Net profit as per P&L account, add inadmissible expenses, less incomes chargeable under other heads or exempted incomes. So these two calculations you know very well. After doing these two calculations, what we have to do? We have to add salary or remuneration to partners if already debited to profit and loss account. That means all the partners, salary, commission, bonus, anything given to any partner that will come under this category. So add salary or remuneration to all the partners. So once we add these item, that will become what? Book profit. So to that book profit, out of book profit, what you have to do? We have to less salary to working partners, only to working partners. So as per the prescribed limit, that limit will be discussed later. So after deducting salary to working partners, you will get what? Income from business. So next comes all other categories. Income from other heads, that means income from house property, income from other source, that will become different from category. So to be computed under each separately, income from house property, income from other source, that will become what? Different heads. So by adding all the heads, income from business, income from house property, income from other source, any other category, it will become what? Gross total income. So from that gross total income, what do we do? Less deductions starting from ATC to ATG or any deductions we have to compute, we have to find out. And after deducting these calculations, you will become what? It will become total income. So while doing assessment of partnership form, we have to remember certain important points. The first one is remuneration paid to non-working partners will not be taken as deduction from book profit. So they will specify in the question itself overall the working partners and overall the non-working partners. So remuneration paid to, that means salary, bonus, anything paid to non-working partners will not be taken as deduction from book profit. First point. The second point is maximum limit of interest on capital allowable is 12%, excess is disallowable. So which is very simple to calculate, they'll give the interest on capital. We just have to find out whether it is more than 12% or not. If it is more than 12%, the remaining will be disallowable. So remaining will come under disallowable expenses. Next is, in case of working partners, so in case of only working partners, payments of remunerations are allowable as deduction subject to the following limits. and excess, if any, is disallowable. So we have discussed while discussing about what format. Less salary to working partners as per prescribed limit. So that prescribed limit comes under here. So salary to working partners as per the prescribed limit. So in case of working partners, payments of remunerations, for example salary, bonus, anything, are allowable as per deduction subject to the following limits. Excess, if any, is disallowable. The first part is on first 3 lakhs of the book profit, or in the case of loss, ₹1,50,000, or at the rate of 90% of the book profit, whichever is more. So your book profit, after calculating the book profit, if you get your book profit as more than 3 lakhs rupees, on the first 3 lakhs of the book profit, the limit is that what? ₹1,50,000, or at the rate of 90% of the book profit, whichever is more. Next, B, on the balance of the book profit at the rate of 60% will be taken. Next, whatever the calculation you do for A and B all together, and we have to add these two, A and B, and remuneration paid to working partners, that means actual remuneration paid to working partners, out of these two, whichever is less, will be taken for the calculation. A plus B and remuneration paid to working partners, which will be given in the question. So total of these two and remuneration paid to working partners, between these two, whichever is less, will be taken for the calculation. So this is about the certain rules that we have to follow while calculating the assessment of partnership firm. We have to solve the sum as per the format, where we have to follow the format of business or total income. Firstly, we have to start with the business incomes and after to go with the other heads. And after finding all the heads of incomes, we have to take the deductions. So we shall go with the questions. We will discuss the question first. So they have given partnership firm's business P&L account. So we have to do the business incomes. So firstly, we have to start with the income from business. So for calculating income from business, what we have to find out? We have to find out inadmissible expenses and incomes chargeable under other heads. These two are the main ingredients to calculate income from business. So inadmissible expenses, we have to figure it out of the P&L account. So salary to staff is not inadmissible, it is admissible, which is related to business. Salary to partners are also related to business. Interest on capital is on the partner's capital, so we have to calculate for that later. Office expenses, it is not inadmissible. Municipal tax, it is inadmissible, because municipal tax is related to house property, which is given in the adjustment itself. Municipal taxes and repairs relate to house property let out. So municipal tax is inadmissible, repairs inadmissible. Bad debts is given and provision for bad debts is given. So as per a previous discussion, whenever they give bad debts and provision for bad debts, we have to take provision for bad debts as inadmissible. So we will take it as inadmissible, provision for bad debts. Donations, 4,000. So there is an adjustment regarding donations. What it says? Donations include ₹1,000 paid as a subscription to trade association and balance to the National Defense Fund. So out of 4,000 donations, 1,000 paid to trade associations. When it is a trade association, which is purely related to business, whereas the balance paid to National Defense Fund. So out of 4,000, 1,000 is related to business, whereas 3,000 related to other source, whereas defense fund, we have contributed as a donation to National Defense Fund. So 3,000 will be taken as inadmissible expenses, only 3,000. Depreciation, ₹6,000. For that, there is an adjustment. Depreciation allowable as per rule is ₹5,000. 6,000 is given, whereas adjustment is 5,000. So what we have to take? We have to take 6,000 minus 5,000, 1,000 as disallowable. Next, on the credit side, gross profit, rent from house property, interest on POSB account. These two are the incomes. So when it said rent from house property, he has received a rent. So which rent? House property rent. The house property is let out property. So we shall take this as what? Under income from house property. Again, while calculating business income also, we shall take this one as what? Income under other head, other source we have to do. Interest on POSB account, we shall take under what? Under income from business itself, as what? As incomes chargeable under head, under other head. So this is about the question. Solutions for this question: computation of firm's total income for the assessment year 2011-12. So firstly, we shall continue with the start with the income from business. Net profit as per P&L account 4000. So P&L account, what they have given? Net profit how much in total? 4000. That will be taken. Net profit 4000. Add inadmissible expenses. So as per the format of income from business, what we have to add? Inadmissible expenses or disallowable expenses or incomes which are not related to business. First item is interest on capital. So we just skip interest on capital discussion while discussing the question, right? Interest on capital A 24,000, B 24,000, 48,000. But the rule says interest on capital is limited to up to 12%. If excess, if any, it will be disallowable. So as per the rule, while calculating assessment of business firm, interest on capital is exempted up to 12%. If it is more than 12%, it will be disallowable. So we will calculate interest on capital for A and B. We will check whether it is more than 12% or less than that. So they have directly given as how much? 24,000, 24,000. We don't know whether it is 12% or less than that or more than that. So firstly, we will calculate interest on capital separately on 1,50,000, because 1,50,000 is their capital. On that 1,50,000, we'll calculate 12%. We shall calculate whether 12% of 1,50,000 is 24,000 or related. Interest on capital of A is 24,000. So interest at 12% is 18,000. That is 12% is less than 24,000. So whatever they have provided is more than the 12%. So excess whatever they have charged is disallowable. So 24,000 is given interest as per the rule. Till 12% is allowable, excess if any will be disallowable. So 12% on 1,50,000 is 18,000, remaining is disallowable. And for B also same thing, interest on capital of B 24,000, interest at 20,000 is 18,000, remaining is disallowable. So as per our discussion on the questions, municipal tax disallowable, repairs disallowable, provision for doubtful debts disallowable, donations disallowable, deposition with calculation disallowable. So municipal tax for house property, it is related to house property, so it is disallowable for business. Repairs house property, disallowable 500. PDD 2500 disallowable. Depreciation 6000 minus 5000 as per our discussion. 1000 disallowable. Donations out of 4000, 1000 is allowable, which was for trade association. So remaining 3000 is National Defense Fund. So National Defense Fund is disallowable. So total disallowable expenses are how much? 21,000. So 4000 plus 21,000, it will be 25,000. So next step is what? Less incomes taxable under other head or other heads or exempted incomes. So there are two different incomes. One is rent from house property, interest on post office savings bank account. These two are the other heads. So this will be taken. Rent from house property and interest on POSB account, 12,000 plus 1,000, it will be 13,000. So 25,000 minus 13,000, it will be 12,000. So as per the format, what we have to add? We have to add salary to partners if already debited to P&L account. So salary to partner is already debited to P&L account. So salary to partners A 34,000, B 34,000, 68,000. That will be taken here. Salary to A 34, salary to B 34, in total 68,000. So we'll get what? Book profit. Next, salary to working partners. So this consists of calculation. So whatever the salary paid to working partners, that will be taken for the calculation with the some adjustments. So as we discussed regarding the important points regarding assessment of partnership firm, it says in case of working partners, payment of remunerations are allowable as deductions subject to the following limits as per section 40B. On the first 3 lakhs of the book profit, or in case of loss, rupees 1,50,000, or at the rate of 90% of the book profit, whichever is more. Here the book profit is very less because it is how much? 80,000, which is very less than the 3 lakh rupees. So we now need to take 3 lakh and what? 3 lakh and on the balance of the book profit. Here we end our calculations, because a book profit is less than that of 3 lakh rupees. If it is more than 3 lakh rupees, we would have calculated as separately A and B for A section, and for remaining amount will be B section. Here there won't be any B calculations, there will be only A calculation, because our book profit is very much less than the 3 lakh rupees. So here it is how much book profit? 80,000. So we have to calculate in this way. Salary to working partners A and B, this is about actual salary. So after calculating actual salary, what we have to do? We have to go with the salary allowable under section 40B. What it says? 90% of the book profit of rupees 80,000. Rule says first 3 lakhs, because so as per the rule, what it says, on first 3 lakh rupees we have to charge 90%. So till 3 lakhs we have to charge only 90%. So we have got book profit as rupees 80,000. So 90% of 80,000 is 72,000, or 1,50,000 out of these two, whichever is more. 90% of 80,000 and 1,50,000, whichever is more, is rupees 1,50,000. And this amount and the actual salary paid to working partners is how much? Total 60,000. 60,000 and this 1,50,000, out of these two we have to select what? Whichever is less as salary. 68,000. 1,50,000 and actual salary paid to working partners, rupees 68,000. Between these two we have to select 68,000. So we have to take this 68,000 and less from 80,000. So 80,000 minus 68,000, you'll get 12,000. This is about income from business. So what we have to do? We have to go with the calculations of salary to working partners as per the rule. Firstly, what we have to take? We have to take whatever the salary paid to working partners, that will be taken. That will be considered as what? Actual salary paid. So next, we have to follow the provisions of 40B. What it says? On first 3 lakhs, we have to calculate 90%. Here we got less than the 3 lakh rupees. So we have to calculate 90% of 80,000, 72,000, or 1,50,000. 90% of 80,000 and 1,50,000, between these two, whichever is more, we have to select. So 90% of 80,000 is 72,000, or 1,50,000, between these two, whichever is more. This amount and actual salary paid is how much? 68,000. So 68,000 or 1,50,000, whichever is less, will be taken. 68,000. So out of book profit, we have to minus what? 68,000. You will get what? Income from business as it is 12,000. Next comes next head as what? Income from house property. So rent received is given, municipal tax was given, so that will be taken for the calculation. So rent received is how much? 12,000. Municipal tax is 2,000. So rent received minus municipal tax, it will be annual value. So you get the annual value as rupees 10,000. Minus deductions under section 24, which says 30% of annual deductions is rupees how much? 3,000. So annual value is 10,000. So 30% of annual value will be 3,000. So 10 will be 7,000. That is your income from house property. So 12,000 income from business, 7,000 income from house property. There is no other source income. So you'll calculate only two heads of incomes, which is income from business and income from house property. All together you will get gross total income as rupees 19,000. So after calculating gross total income, we have to consider was less deductions under section 80C to 80G or any other deductions. So we have only one deductions as per the question. What it is? See the question. Donations includes rupees 1,000 paid to subscription to trade association, that is not a deduction, and the balance to National Defense Fund. This is our deduction. So out of donations, 1,000 is related to business, whereas balance 3,000 is related to National Defense Fund. So that will come under what? Deduction under section 80G. So donation to National Defense Fund, 3,000. So 19,000 minus 3,000, you get 16,000. That will be your what? Total income. So this is about income from partnership form.